Hello treasures, welcome back to the channel. I'm so sorry for the long break, but I believe that we are back and better. So today we're continuing the healthy seeds and we're going to our first seed, which is the sunflower seed. But before I continue, a disclaimer, please, before you start taking any of those seeds and you have a health condition, make sure you take your doctor or your healthcare provider along with you. Another thing, if you want to use it to control anything, you have to be patient. I have to try to meet the daily required dose and duration. So with that said, let's get into this. So sunflower seeds are gotten from the flower head of the sunflower plant. Now they're encased in a shell, and the shell has white stripes. I think I have it here. Let me get it so we'll be seeing it. If you need it, I'm also your best plug for it. So this is what it looks like. Can we see it? Take that. So it's tiny. Yes. It's about half an inch. So that's what it looks like. So it has a black shell that has white stripes and is nutty in flavor. And it is full of nutrients. So you have to open up the shell, this here. Then you bring out the seed, which is usually whitish or milk in color. So this is what it looks like. I hope to attach pictures. So can you see it as against this? So that's what it looks like when you've removed the shell. Now this little seed, like we know, is filled with a lot of nutrients and is so rich in antioxidants. They are rich in healthy fats, they are rich in magnesium, they contain folic acid, they contain the B vitamins, they contain vitamin E, selenium, so many minerals that are very good for our body. What are the benefits of sunflower seeds? Number one benefit is that it decreases the risk of developing high blood pressure, cardiovascular diseases, and even hypercholesterolemia. The second benefit of sunflower seed is that it boosts the immunity. It boosts the immunity because it contains zinc and selenium, and these help in the production and maturation of immune cells that help in fighting infections and diseases in the body. The third thing it does is that it also has anti-inflammatory properties because it contains some minerals and some elements that help in decreasing inflammation. What is inflammation? Inflammation has to do with swelling, maybe arthritis and other swelling in the body. So it helps to, it is anti-inflammatory. Another thing it does is that it boosts energy. Remember, it contains vitamin B's, and vitamin B's are very good in metabolism. So it helps in boosting our energy. It also contains selenium that will help increase blood flow to your brain and also giving you some boost in your energy level. Another thing it does is that it's very good for the reproductive organ. It contains vitamin E, it contains zinc, and it contains folate. Folate, we know, is very good for women of childbearing age because it helps in the development of the baby. It helps to prevent some birth defects in children. Also, zinc is so good in epithelial regeneration and generation. Even vitamin E is so good for the skin. So it helps the pregnant woman's skin. It gives the pregnancy glow when taken appropriately. So it contains vitamin E. Another thing it does is that it detoxifies. Remember, I said earlier that they are rich in antioxidants. And we know, what is toxins? Toxins are chemicals, unwanted substances, unwanted elements in our body. So Sunflower has antioxidants that helps mop out these things from our body. It is also excellent for the skin, like I said before. It keeps the skin clear and glowing because it's rich in vitamin E. Because they are rich in antioxidants, they help in fighting catarrh, cough, and cold. That's the flu. Another thing, they contain flavonoids, which are anti-cancerous substances. So these flavonoids help in preventing cancer. They also help in healthy bone because they contain calcium. They are very good for weight loss because they are rich in fiber, and we know that fiber is very good for the gut. It also helps in delaying the feel of hunger. So in so doing, it allows metabolism to occur and also helping the person to lose weight. There is iron, which helps to prevent anemia. So you can see that sunflower seeds are really, really very good for the health when taken very well. So recommended seven is suggested that you take at least 1/4 of a cup daily, because remember, it has some calorie content. Let me read them out. It has calories, it has proteins, it has fats, it has carbohydrates, and it has fiber. So even if you say you're taking it for to lose weight, don't forget that it has some calories and it has carbohydrates, so you have to be careful. So now, how can we take it? What are the ways we can incorporate sunflower seeds? See them, I have here. So if you need them, make sure you let me know. So how can we incorporate these sunflower seeds into our diet? You can start by eating it that way. You can eat it that way, but remember, you have to remove the shell. So you remove the shell and eat it that way. You can also start by roasting them, frying them. Now, another thing I do is I sprinkle them into my salad. I also use them to do smoothie. Very good in smoothies. You can add them to your oatmeal. Another thing you can do, how you can incorporate sunflower seeds into your meal, is that I watched a video recently by Flo Chinyere. I will try to look for the link of that video and drop it in the description box, where she used this because she's not in a place where she can easily get melon seeds. That's our egusi. So she actually used sunflower seeds in place of egusi. Remember when I opened it, it's just like the color of egusi, and that soup just is except you know what egusi tastes like. That's what melon seeds taste like. That's when you know that this is not egusi. Another thing you can use, you can add it to your baking things you bake. So now, what ailments can you use it to prevent? Cardiovascular diseases. Cardiovascular disease has to do with diseases affecting the heart and the vessels. And one of the first culprits is high blood pressure. You can also use it in taking care of bone health, skin health, and even heart-related diseases. Like I said earlier, cardiovascular diseases. Now, what is the caution? Remember, do not eat the shell. Do not eat the shell. Make sure that the one you get is fresh. Because most times when you get the ones that are already sprouting, you know what is sprouting when a new plant is growing from a seed. Most of them already have some bacterial growth, some bacteria or fungal growth ongoing. So you have to be careful. And remember, I said earlier, eat in moderation. Then remember my disclaimer. If you want to use this to prevent any ailment, but you already have an already existing illness, make sure you carry your health care provider along with you. So there comes the end of our talk about sunflower seeds. Do well to ask any question you want to ask about the seed or any other seed. Till I come your way next time when we'll be talking about flaxseed. God bless you, and remember to subscribe and turn on your notification bell. Bye bye.